Hi, Dana G here. You know, a big part of the Olympic Games is the legacy it leaves behind in terms of motivating young athletes to strive for gold, silver, or bronze medals. The Paralympic Games are no different. We're here at GF Strong today to meet with some people who look to those games to help them in their recovery.
Well, I was in University of Alberta, and I was a dance major. Mm-hmm. I got hit by a drunk driver. And so I was the first successful reattached amputee. So it was the 80s. Microsurgery was a really big thing. So I was in the hospital for almost 2 years.
20 years later, and what, 28 surgeries you had?
Oh yeah, 28, 30, somewhere up there. I stopped counting after about 25.
So Joanne, the Paralympics, what does that mean for someone like you who's, you know, coming back from having an amputation and who was a skier and who I'm guessing by the look on your face and talking to you wants to ski again? What does it mean to have that here in Vancouver and to see all those athletes up close?
It's huge. It's hugely inspiring. I mean, it's just, it makes you want to work harder. Mm-hmm. You know, come, even though, you know, you had a really tough night, just get up and come and, it was so uplifting for the community, for this team. It's, yeah, I wish they did it every year.
Now, are we going to see you in a Canadian suit one day competing?
As a dream come true. I would love that.
Yeah? As someone who's working with amputees all the time, I mean, it must motivate you as well to see that there is those steps that people can, you know, those goals they can reach.
Actually, that's a really interesting question as to what motivates me. And you're absolutely right. It's when you see somebody who is excelling at a level of ability and expertise when you haven't seen that before as a therapist, it absolutely knocks your socks off.
Now, you're a sledge hockey player.
Yes,
well,
I am.
Right?
I just joined. I started in November.
Right.
And I've probably played 15 or 16 practice game. We're going in the tournament April 15th in Edmonton, and I'm looking forward to get my shot at Team Canada.
It's a tough sport too. Like, you get knocked around pretty good in that.
Yes, that's the part I like.
That's the part you like, really?
The part I like.
So Christian, I guess you're playing sledge hockey. You want to hopefully play for Team Canada. Tell me about having the Paralympics here in Vancouver recently. What did that mean for you as an athlete?
First of all, when you get to a certain age, let's say past 50, you sit in front of the TV and you look at what might have been if you had been lucky enough when you were young to get the training, the funding, and suddenly, whoop, because of an accident, there's this window that opens that allows you maybe to become an Olympian. This is called the C-Leg. It's programmed with sensors and a chip processor. It works on batteries, and it understands what I'm doing as far as walking, so that I don't fall, which is the biggest issue being an amputee.